The Copley High School engineering team consists of six senior engineering students: Jacob Druga, Chad Brown, Ryan McLaren, Jalen Sarah, Armando Consolacion, with team leaders Sydney Demetrico and Greg White. Here at Copley, we have a woodshop program, a visual communication and technology program, and three levels of engineering, drafting, and design. This EHS engineering team works on an assortment of projects, from making and competing in the Akron Soapbox Derby to building a 3D printer. For the 2017 SourceAmerica Design Challenge, we are working with Weaver SecurShred, a non-for-profit organization. SecurShred is located in Akron, Ohio, about 15 minutes from our school. Here, people with disabilities shred classified documents from various sources. When we contacted SecurShred, they had an issue with lottery ticket rolls. They had to somehow get the cardboard center out of the roll, as their shredders could not handle its density. When we met with Jack Skinner, the general manager of SecurShred, he showed us firsthand what happens when the entire roll gets put in the shredder. As a result, the roll starts spinning out, creating a major safety issue for the workers as they would have to unjam the shredder. SecurShred's solution was to unwind the roll directly into the shredder, putting their hand extremely close to the blade. The process was too dangerous for any employees with disabilities, so only the managers at SecurShred could do this. The process was also very time-consuming, taking up to 5 minutes for one small roll. In the process of brainstorming, our team set aside a few goals, which include a low-cost system, an increase in production rate, ensuring the worker's safety, providing opportunities to complete larger requests by employers, creating new position at Weaver, as right now there's no way for anyone to perform this task safely. When our team started brainstorming, we used the engineering process. We started with trying to push the cardboard rolls out, but it was a hassle. There seemed to be an adhesive that connected the cardboard center to the paper. Next, we took the roll to a bandsaw, and using a basic claw, cut the roll in half. After the roll was cut, the cardboard center came out easily, so we sought to refine the design. Once we knew the best way to cut the rolls in half, we started to make our final design. When we talked to Jack Skinner, he arranged for us to receive a used bandsaw from SecurShred. If not donated, this would have cost us around $500.
Next, we set to make a finished rig to safely cut our rolls and dispose of them the way SecurShred desires. The first part of the machine is a slider cut to fit any size lottery roll. The slider has a handle built in for an easier way to push and cut the rolls. The slider goes through a frame so that it stays aligned with the blade of the bandsaw. This way, the rolls are cut perfectly every time. Due to a cover over the slider and frame, no one can come in close proximity with the blade and therefore cannot get hurt. At one end of the machine, we have a metal slide bolted to the bandsaw. This slide is for the rolls to slide down into a box after the roll has been cut. SecurShred can then easily unload the box right into their shredder. Additionally, there is a folding table on the side of our bandsaw that will hold extra rolls for easy access to improve production time. Under the bandsaw, there is a cabinet that stores extra sliders for various size rolls and general storage. The bandsaw is bolted to a wooden frame that is on four locking wheels. This way, anyone is capable of moving the bandsaw to the location of choice. Safety was a major concern for our machine. As said before, there is a guard that will prevent anyone from getting too close to the blade. The locking wheels prevent the machine from rolling without someone moving it. There are also two buttons on the machine. The first one uses a key to turn the machine on and off. The second button is an emergency stop that completely shuts down the machine. Cost was also a very important factor in the production of our machine. We kept a low-cost system while meeting the production goals. This will keep SecurShred competitive and improves the mass production of similar machines. In review, we improved the safety and time factor of the process. The old way of having to feed the rolls directly into the shredder's teeth was not only time intensive, but also very hazardous. Now with our improved machine, the workers cannot get anywhere near the blade, and the supervisors at Weaver can keep the machine on or off at their choosing. We also have an additional table and shelf for easy access to rolls and for storage. Overall, we improved the production rate by 750%, going from 5 minutes to an improved 12 seconds to shred one roll. Because of our effort, any employee at Weaver SecurShred can now complete this job safely and effectively.